Here are four rules for victims of narcissism. Number one is this: document the truth. If you have watched my videos, I'm sure you have in the past, hopefully you have in the past, you know how important this is. Now, you are the victim of a narcissist, and you know that what's going to happen, or probably already is happening, is you are going to be the victim of a smear campaign. It's not just that the narcissist used you for supply, maybe stole from you, maybe abused you by putting you down, or whatever they do, and they've got a whole bag of tricks to take supply out of you, supply being whatever boosts the narcissist ego. And people like this guy or like this girl because, well, narcissists understand for them to get supply out of people, people have to accept them. And for people to accept them, they've got to be likable. So narcissists, most narcissists, even covert narcissists, learn early. Maybe it's just innate. Maybe they don't learn it, but they learn early that they got to be likable, that they've got to be charismatic. They've got to exude that personality that other people embrace and have confidence in. So you're up against that. So once you find yourself in the throes of narcissistic abuse, now you get this challenge of convincing other people, not just for your sake, but for their sake, because they potentially will be victim too. You've got the task of convincing people this is a bad guy. I mean, this sweet, lovable person is evil. I was watching a documentary on YouTube yesterday, and there was this sweet, lovable young woman who murdered her husband. You know, there were character witnesses. They showed part of the court case against her, and there were character witnesses who, you know, co-workers and friends, who testified what a sweet, loving, wonderful person she was. And I don't doubt they were sincere. They were serious, because this woman likely projected herself, presented herself as sweet and charming. It's what narcissists do. They wear that sweet, charming mask. And people tend not to believe, hey, this can't be the bad guy. I know this. This is such a wonderful person. Well, not if you document it. And this woman, I probably shouldn't go into all this, but apparently what she did is she took her husband. I think she was like a nurse or whatever, so she took her husband, knocked him out with some kind of a sedative, and chomped him up in bits, put him in suitcases, and chucked him in the ocean. Sweet, lovable little woman, you know, but those suitcases washed up on shore. I mean, you know, she was ultimately found out. Turns out, the police discovered, yeah, those were her suitcases. I don't know how they found that out, but they did. And anyhow, she was convicted. If I remember, she got life in prison. But she was so sweet. I mean, she was so nice. You got to document the truth, because these people will fool other people. They fool me all the time. I can't tell you how many times that I have been fooled. Nowhere nearly as much as I was in the past. Because with nearly 70 years behind me, I've learned a thing or two, but hey, I'm still not there. Still learning. That's why I make these videos, passing on to you, you know, some of these things that I've gone through. So hopefully I can help you go through something that is similar. But they're very convincing. So you got to document what's going on. That is my suggestion. Number two is how many times have we said, go Grey Rock? And then how many times have we said, you can't always do that because you may be in a workplace where you can't just break off relations with somebody. I mean, you can't just not talk to them or look at them or just not be in their presence. That's not always possible. Sometimes it's a family member, and you gotta live with these people. So not just work with them, you gotta live with them. But outside of that, the best, in my opinion, the best way to deal with a narcissist is to go Grey Rock. Ghost them. Just stay away from them. That is a rule, in my opinion, for a victim of narcissism. So when I see myself being victimized by a narcissist being somebody who's controlling, who thinks they are superior in just about every way than everybody else, that would include me. They think they're superior to me, and once I get it and I find these people are dangerous and they're toxic and they're hurting me emotionally, the thing to do is break off or contact whenever possible. Just go Grey Rock. So in the, what should we call this, our bag of tricks, our rules for victims of narcissism is, rule number two is learn to go Grey Rock. Number three is learn from your experiences. Now, again, we've talked about this a lot in the past. And I've mentioned in the past, I'm going to say it again, that your experience with a narcissist has certain silver linings. And one of those silver linings is you've gone through the experience, and because you have experienced the abuse, you can do a couple things with that. Number one, you can avoid being abused again. And number two, you can take your experience and you can help others who are facing or potentially facing abuse. Same kind of abuse. It's what I'm doing now. I'm taking my experiences, what I've learned, and I'm sharing that with you. You do with it what you want to, you know. But my job is to share that with you. By the way, I got to say this, that noise you hear in the background, that's a window air conditioner. I forgot to turn it off before I started. You know, it's early in the season. I forget that it comes on, so I'm not used to it. Number three is learn from your experience and watch for those silver linings. Now, one of the silver linings of being abused by the narcissist is the smear campaign. Now, that's hurtful. That's painful, right? But it has an advantage. I see it as a friend cleaning process. So the narcissist goes through your list of friends. They want to break up your social network so that you can't tell the truth about them, which is one of the primary reasons. And the other reason is they just like to control you. Just another way of getting supply. But they want to destroy your circle of friends, your social network. They want to obliterate it. How is that a silver lining? Well, people who are your true friend, not going to fall for it. Sad to say that in my experience, probably, I don't know, maybe 80% of my so-called friends, acquaintances, people that I knew, believed the narcissist. Typically, that was because they didn't know me well, or they didn't know the narcissist well, or both. But the silver lining is about 20%, give or take, didn't fall for it. So now, hey, thank you, narcissist, for cleaning up my friends. Now I know who I can trust and who I can no longer trust. And some of those people who are no longer in my social circle, not that I had a big one to begin with, but those people who are no longer in my social circle, guess what? They are narcissists themselves. I didn't see it coming, but it's a good thing to get them out of my life. Number four is this. Do what we just said, and that is bask in the silver lining. It's not just enough to recognize it, but it is important now that we go forward and we use what we have learned and experienced. So now we know to avoid those fake friends who became flying monkeys, who became agents of the narcissist, who are potentially toxic. We know to stay away from them or to minimize our contact with them. So we are basking now in the silver lining. We are basking when we go forward with our good friends. That is comprised of those individuals who have heard the smear campaign from the narcissist directly or from one of his flying monkeys, his agents, his narcissist by proxy, and they're still your good friends. So these are people you can hang out with. So you're kind of basking in that. So this is the afterglow of being burned by a narcissist. Okay, at the time it seemed to be horrific, but it was actually kind of a cleansing process. And now you feel pretty good, right? So I don't know about you. I don't like to take a cold shower, but after you come out of it, you feel pretty good. So think of the smear campaign, your experience with narcissist, as a very uncomfortable cold shower. But now it's over, nearly over. So now you feel really good, right? You can go forward. You can see clearly now. Bask in that. Embrace it. Enjoy it. You see those two rectangles on the screen. If you want to keep on talking, well, let's keep hanging out. All you got to do is click on one of those two rectangles and the conversation goes on. If not, thanks for stopping by and see y'all next time.